It's a new year and I want to start things off by doing some projects just to update my printers and show them some love. And I'm going to start off with my V0 because it's been kind of sadly neglected for a while, pretty much since I got the Micron. So the first thing it's going to get is a new extruder. This is the Roto Vitamins extruder by E3D. It takes the drive from the Roto toolhead, which is a planetary drive, like an orbiter or a Galileo. It's a little different in that it also combines a geared output drive for the filament, where the Galileo and orbiter have the filament drive directly on the output shaft. The Roto relies on printed housings to adapt over to different mounting systems. So this is the Dragon Burner V8, which is one of the configurations that they support. There's also housings for the Stealth Burner Clockwork 2 for the Voron toolheads, as well as, I believe, an LGX compatible housing so that you can adapt that over to other toolheads as you like. It has this latching filament tension arm so that you can easily load and unload filament, and then it auto tensions back in. This one also has the optional filament sensor installed, so it's very small, very lightweight. There's a runout sensor in here. There's also this little action button on the front that you can program using macros, and there's also an indicator LED that will let you know the state of the filament sensor. There is a USB toolhead available for the Roto that mounts on the side, which is what these larger holes are for. But since I already have my EBB36 set up, I've just adapted that over to mount on the back. A couple things that I learned when I was putting this toolhead together: the Dragon Burner housing for the Roto Vitamins is not compatible with the Orbiter 2 spacing on the hot end mount. So you're going to need to reprint that part, whether you have an orbiter or a different extruder on your Dragon Burner currently. You have to go to the repo and look for the version that has no extruder listed, and then this will fit properly. The other thing to be aware of is that the extruder motor is turned 90 degrees relative to an Orbiter 2. So Orbiter 2 toolhead boards will not work with the Roto Vitamins. I believe this one is from a sail fin extruder. I will throw a link to that in the description of the video. Other than needing that new part, everything seems to be working fine here. The other project I'm going to do right now with the V0 is I'm going to install one of the mini fridge front door kits. This is a scaled down version of Whopping Potchard's clicky clack door for the full-sized Vorons. The mini fridge is a 1515 extrusion framed one-piece front door for the V0. It's hinged and then can be removed if you need to open the front for maintenance or if you're printing PLA. It's just another way to kind of cut down on some of the noise and further seal the V0 build chamber. So just another little quick project to do on that, which will make it a little bit better to use. So while I was printing the parts for the Roto Vitamins conversion, I took a look at my Micron and realized that my toolhead was broken. At some point, I used the wrong screw to attach the extruder, which came through the top of the mount, pressed into the 4010 fan, and broke my ducts. You can see there's a chunk missing in the front, and it's split in the back. And while I figured I could reprint another Dragon Burner, because I like the Dragon Burner, I also saw that Hartk, who developed the Micron, has his own toolhead out now called the AntHead, and I decided I'll upgrade to that. The AntHead is a really nice looking little toolhead. It takes a lot of styling cues from the newer Micron R1 styling, so kind of a low poly look. As you can see, there are no holes through the front, for the tool head mounting screws. Those are actually hidden behind this gray part here. If we look at the tool head from the back, you can see some of the modular parts, and here are the screws that attach this to the carriage. So you start off by attaching the hot end mount to the carriage, then the main body goes onto that, and then you can screw the ducts onto the sides, and then finally install your extruder. So this is the same wristwatch G2 that I had on the Dragon Burner. Hartk does have a modified version of this that fits a little bit better on top of the tool head that also is the same dual filament runout sensor version that I have on the Reaper on my V2. I'll eventually swap this over and just reprint those parts and rebuild using this gearing. But for right now, I just want to get this on the Micron and know that I have good duct work on there. Other than that, I am waiting for the Colony Clacker door to come, which is another variation of the Clicky Clack door that's specifically designed for the Micron. So the same thing, it's a 1515 extrusion framed front door that will seal the front of the Micron and help insulate it and keep more heat inside and hopefully cut down a little bit on the noise. I'm beta testing a new hot end fan. This is a new 2510 that cools really well because it's a 20,000 RPM fan, but it is a little bit noisier than the existing Delta that I had in the Dragon Burner previously. Moving on to the big printers, my V2.4 is still going strong. I really need to finally break down and give it the gantry rebuild that I've been planning on for over a year. I've mostly just been dragging my feet, A, because it's not going to be that much fun, and B, I've needed a large printer for some of the projects that I'm working on, and I've come to the realization that I need more than one. Some of the things that I've got coming up, I'm going to be building a box turtle. Eventually, the one that I've been doing the video series on is going to be at the shop on Daniel's V2.4. So I'll be building one for myself that'll be here. And we've also got some other projects coming up that are going to require a lot of printing. So I took advantage of one of the sales that we were doing at the shop, and I have purchased a switch wire, which I'm looking forward to building soon. I think it's going to make a great secondary printer. I don't like running prints overnight, mostly because my bed backs up directly to the garage and you can hear the printers while they're going. So it's not always great when I'm trying to get some sleep. So if I can't print all the time, then I'm going to have more machines to be able to print. So in comes the switch wire, which should be a very capable secondary printer to back up my V2. One of the smaller projects that I've done recently is I upgraded my VLMP to VLMP version 2. It has a much wider base with these storage compartments for keeping tips and inserts or parts. It has trays in the back for making sure that you have easy access to your inserts. There are these inlays that actually give you a nice little crosshair of where your soldering iron is going to hit. And I've just installed one of our new 3D Maker Parts soldering irons on it that will live there so that I always have it ready to go without having to change out the tip on my weller and switch back and forth. The iron is a 60 watt, 200 to 450 degree adjustable analog soldering iron that runs off 110. We also have a kit of heat insert tips that go from M2 to M8. And what I really like is that these thread on and off the adapter. So if you're like me and you're just going to leave the soldering iron in your press all the time, you can just leave that there. And then when you're doing different sizes of inserts, you can just change that out and never even have to bother with taking out the whole assembly and swapping that. It's just a little quality of life thing to have the insert press always ready to go and not have to switch back and forth with my other soldering iron. So that's where things are right now. I've got the box turtle to finish up, That just needs to be wired into the V2, and then I start dealing with firmware and software. I've got the 3MS that I need to get back to because I want to finish that build. And we've got some videos coming that are more printing oriented, that are more about some interesting projects that you can do with your 3D printer. But we're going to keep bringing you more content about printers themselves, because there's lots of stuff happening in the 3D printing space. And to close things out, I'd like to hear from you. I know a lot of people have commented that they like the edited videos that we put out because they tend to be shorter and to the point versus, you know, very long live streams. But is there any interest in having the occasional live stream? So let us know what you think. We're going to continue bringing you these videos where we talk about projects and products that we think are interesting. We're going to continue doing our Meet the Maker live streams where we talk to people in the 3D printing community about what they're doing and just getting to know them better. We'll continue bringing you coverage from the major 3D printing events that we go to. And we hope that everyone has a happy and healthy 2025 and go out there and print something really cool.